Yo, what's up, guys? James Carter TV and the Philadelphia Eagles have fired Chip Kelly, and I'm going to discuss it here today. Throughout this NFL period where coaches will be fired, I will be talking about each and every coach getting fired and whether or not I agree or disagree with the firings. And then later on in this video, I will slightly recap the games that I was unable to recap yesterday and the day before that, or like the night before that, because I was busy with some things. And I just didn't really feel like the Sunday games were really that significant at all. Of them were blowouts the afternoon and late game. So, but first, let's start with this Philadelphia Eagles firing Chip Kelly. I mean, look, okay? Eagles fans, a lot of you are watching this video, and I know you're rejoicing, a lot of you, and you have reason to be. I have some serious problems with Chip Kelly as a head coach and a general manager, a lot more as a general manager, because when this guy dismantled a team that was full of Pro Bowl talent. I mean, the Eagles have had talent for a decade. I mean, when you have Jeremy Maclin, when you have LaShawn McCoy, Nick Foles was playing really well under Chip Kelly. Now, he wasn't a great Pro Bowl talent, but he was playing well under Chip Kelly, had 7 touchdowns against the Raiders, had all these great statistics and what have you. He was playing really well under Chip Kelly. Chip Kelly gets rid of him, gets rid of LaShawn McCoy, gets rid of Jeremy Maclin, DeSean Jackson, who had a really nice season under Chip Kelly, gets rid of him. And what I have a problem with the Chip Kelly, the head coach, is these guys really don't like Chip Kelly. And that's an issue. You have to relate to your players. You have to be likable to your players, or you have to win a lot of games. And if you can't do either one of those, like if you're going to be that authoritarian, if you're going to be that Hitler type of guy where I'm the leader, you're going to hate me, well, you better win games, because if people hate you and you're not winning games, you're going to be out the door, and now he's out the door. But with that said, I have a huge trepidation, and this, I have a huge caution for Eagles fans when it comes to this firing. Yes, you've gotten rid of Chip Kelly. Yes, let's rejoice. But hold on 1 second. Chip Kelly wasn't a great winning head coach. I'm not saying he was that, but he was a winning head coach. I mean, this guy was 26 and 21. He went 10 and 6, 10 and 6, and 6 and 9 right now. I think they would have won the last week with him. So maybe 7 and 9 the last year, maybe 6 and 10, what have you. But point is this, this is an above average record, okay? Finished above 500 during his time with the Philadelphia Eagles. And you may think, yes, yay, we're getting rid of Chip Kelly, we're gonna start winning games. It's not that simple. Trust me, and trust all these other fans out here that are gonna tell you, a lot of us are happy when we get rid of our head coaches. I experienced this as a Tennessee Titans fan. When we got rid of Mike Munchak, I was happy. But turns out, man, if you don't hire the right guy, you're going to be in trouble. And it's likely that you will not. That's the likely option. Because Chip Kelly was over 500 as a head coach. It is more likely than not that the next guy you hire will not be as good as him. That's the likeliest option. Because Chip Kelly was an above average head coach, because Chip Kelly had more wins than losses, it is now more likely that the next guy you bring in won't have this good as a record. And who are you going to bring in? You have, I think Adam Gase is a front runner for this job. I've heard a couple tidbits about him over the past couple weeks. So let's say Adam Gase, who hasn't proven himself to be a great leader of an entire locker room. He has shown himself to be a nice offensive coordinator, but it's a big jump from being a nice offensive coordinator to being a great head coach of an entire team, especially this defense, which is so talented, but just does not play up to its ability time and time again. So, will you get a guy that's going to post a better record than Chip Kelly? Will you get a guy that's going to come in, be 10-6, be 10-6, and be 6-9 or better? I mean, I don't know. It's easy to say yes. I know. It's easy to say anyone but Chip Kelly, as long as it's not Chip Kelly. It's easy to say that. But I'm telling you, it's a lot easier said than done. Hiring the next guy and him coming in and being more successful than Chip Kelly, it's easier said than done. And if they're able to do it, that's great. And you'll come back to this video and you say, I told you we were going to get the right guy. But man, going 10-6, making the playoffs 10-6, and then 6-9 is not easy to do. It's an above average job that Chip Kelly did in Philadelphia. And going to the playoffs, doing all of that, the next guy may not be that good. You better get it right, or you're going to be looking back saying, man, maybe we made a mistake here. But overall, I like the firing just because you can't have a head coach who the players hate and who isn't making the playoffs and who dismantled the team that they had. I mean, really, the Chip Kelly, the GM, that was the last straw. Because, you know, the players can hate a head coach. It's unfortunate, but you can get away with it. But man, when he dismantled the roster, he wanted full control. He wasted full control. Now you have to say, okay, you have to get rid of this guy. And they need to pick up the phone and call Howie Roseman because, man, this guy drafted a lot of talent. Jeremy Maclin, LeSean McCoy, they got Jason Peters. They have a lot of talent on this roster, or they had before they got rid of it. Chip Kelly got rid of it. DeSean Jackson. I mean, they've been drafting talent for years. I mean, when Chip Kelly inherited this team, this was a team that was not lacking talent. I mean, the Eagles have had talent for a decade. Now, Chip Kelly got rid of it. He's gone. We'll see who you get next because there's some work to be done here, especially offensively. So we'll see where things go from here. Defensively, there's too much talent. Like, you have Fletcher Cox, you have Vinnie Curry, you have D'Amico Ryans, Kiko Alonso, Connor Barwin, Brandon Graham, Malcolm Jenkins, Nolan Carroll, and Byron Maxwell if he finally decides to wake up. I mean, each of those players I just said are either good or should be good in terms of Byron Maxwell. And yet, they're not winning games because EJ Biggers likes to give up 3 touchdowns a week. And there, you know, there's some nice pieces. But I think if someone can take over this team, like, I think you guys could look after a defensive head coach here. I think if you can get in like a Sean McDermott from the Carolina Panthers, this could be a really, really good defense. I think the problem with this defense was they weren't motivated under Chip Kelly and Billy Davis, the defensive coordinator. And the way the offense was structured, the way the offense liked to score, like how many points and however many minutes or seconds or whatever, and occasionally they would go 3 and out, and the defense was on the field too much, and they just started mailing it in. I think you can start being a defensive team, get a good running back in there, start running the football. You can keep Bradford, but make this a running and defensive team, because I think there's enough talent on the defense to be a really good defense in the NFL. There's a lot of talent on this defense. Now, maybe you need a little cornerback here, maybe you need a little free safety there, but I think this could be a really, really good defense if you can mold your team around the run game and the defense. Don't leave it all on Sam Bradford. Sam Bradford isn't good enough. These wide receivers aren't good enough to lead the team to many points. Now, Jordan Matthews is good, but Nelson Agholor has been a bust thus far. Now, maybe he'll improve next year, but thus far, he's been a bust. Riley Cooper isn't good enough. You know, they don't have anyone good enough in that wide receiving core. So, I say build a good run game and live off your defense. Hire a Sean McDermott out of Carolina, and then mold your team after the defense. What's the defensive coordinator for the Patriots? I can't remember his name right now. Matt Patricia. Someone like that, I think, would be good for Philly. I don't think they should go offensive coordinator route, but I think that's what they might do. They may go Adam Gase. I keep hearing Adam Gase, so I expect to see Adam Gase. I really am. Now, what is Chip Kelly going to do from here? A lot of people want to point and connect the dots to Tennessee. Now, I'm a Tennessee Titans fan, and I'm conflicted. I know this to be true. If Chip Kelly comes here, our offense is going to be good. All right, now we have to get some wide receivers in here and some running backs in here and some offensive line in here. But you cannot deny the magic Marcus Mariota and Chip Kelly have together. You cannot deny this. And if Nick Foles can run this offense, can get 7 touchdowns in this offense, I'm afraid to know what Marcus Mariota can do in that Chip Kelly offense. The problem is, that's it. That's the only positive Chip Kelly brings, because he brings issues in terms of not being able to relate to his players. He's been a bad general manager thus far, so how can he bring in the talent needed for Marcus Mariota to grow and to develop into that dominant quarterback we know he can be? And the defense needs some work as well, and Chip Kelly hasn't shown a great ability to help a defense, because I think he's been hurting this defense in Philadelphia, because I think there's too much talent over there, and yet they're not playing up to their talent. So there's some issues there with Chip Kelly, more issues than the great positive would be, yes, a great offense, but man, we have too many issues that Chip Kelly cannot fix. So I'm going to say no to Chip Kelly. I think he's better off going to college or Miami. I think Ryan Tannehill would be a great fit with Chip Kelly. Ryan Tannehill's been struggling lately. This has not been a good year for him, but I think Chip Kelly could go to Miami, put Ryan Tannehill into a nice spread system. I think it'd be a good fit for that system, and they could put up some points down there with Miami with Ryan Tannehill, Jarvis Landry, if they re-sign Lamar Miller. I think that'd be a good fit down there. But besides that, go back to college. You know, go back to college. NFL may not be for you. Miami or nothing. I think that's the way they Chip Kelly has to look, but we'll see what he wants to do. All right, now let me recap the games that I was unable to recap. Let's start with the Monday Night Football game. The Broncos beat the Bengals, 20-17 in overtime. You know, I predicted this game. Brock Osweiler played good enough to win. I still think they should stick with him instead of Peyton Manning. I just think Peyton Manning has been absolutely awful in 2015. I think he's been the worst starting quarterback in 2015 outside of Zach Mettenberger and Kellen Moore. So I think they'd be better served starting Brock Osweiler throughout the playoffs. I think they could win a Super Bowl with Brock Osweiler, but you know, we'll see what they decide to do. Not much to discuss here, but the Bengals, and this is what I was talking about. So remember that Patriots game this week when the Patriots messed up the coin toss, right? And everybody was like, oh my God, the Patriots lost the game. And I said, who cares? The only one that should care is the Pittsburgh Steelers. And they shouldn't even be that mad, because if the Steelers handled their business, they wouldn't have needed the Jets to lose. So who cares that the Patriots lost? It doesn't matter, because the Bengals lost. The Patriots are going to win next week. They're going to have the number one seed. Who cares? It never mattered to me. The only way the Patriots losing that game was going to matter was if the Bengals won last night, the Bengals won next week, the Bengals went to the AFC Championship, and they beat the Patriots. They needed those four things. If one of those four things did not happen, that result wouldn't have mattered. The first thing couldn't even happen. And now no one cares if the Patriots lost. I don't know why anyone was making a big deal about the Patriots losing that game. All right, so the Sunday Night Football game, the Vikings blow out the Giants. I didn't make a video on this because I didn't think there were any takeaways to take from this. I mean, come on. We knew the Vikings were a good team. We know the Giants were a bad team. And with Odell Beckham out, forget it. The Cardinals blew up the Packers. This is kind of significant because, man, the Packers are just struggling. And my now Super Bowl pick, I'm on the Cardinals bandwagon. The Cardinals are just rolling, guys. And they just blew out the Packers today. Their defense is so good at forcing fumbles, scoring touchdowns. And with that explosive offense the Cardinals have offensively, man, I don't see anyone stopping them. And that includes Carolina. So that was the biggest takeaway from that game. The St. Louis Rams played up for Seattle again. I don't know why they only play up for divisional games. If only they could play up for any other game besides divisional games, they could be in the playoffs right now, but they can't and they won't, so they're gonna finish 8-8. Jeff Fisher's gonna keep his job unbeknownst to me, and they're gonna keep staying in the little rut that they are for the rest of the Jeff Fisher era. All right, next, what was the other game? I can't even remember what the other game was. Let me pull that up. The other game this week, that late afternoon game that I wasn't able to talk about, was the Jaguars against the Saints. Yeah, see, not much to take away here. We both know both their seasons are over. The Saints won. Yeah, good for you guys. You know, main thing, will you keep Sean Payton? And then the Jaguars, they've already announced that they're keeping Gus Bradley. I think this is very stupid. I think this is very stupid. Because I think you can fire Gus Bradley. I think many head coaches would be very interested in this job. Blake Bortles looks like a very good franchise quarterback. How many touchdown passes does he have this year? I think it's 35 plus right now. I think a lot of head coaches would be very interested in coaching the Jacksonville Jaguars right now, but they want to keep Gus Bradley? Fine. I think he'll improve in 2016. I think he'll be 7-9, and I think you're going to keep him again. And I think that's going to be a mistake again. Instead of hiring a new head coach, you guys can make the playoffs next year with this foundation. If you actually get a good NFL competent head coach in there, wow, you guys can make the playoffs, but you won't. Shame, shame, shame. So there you go. Those are my thoughts on Chip Kelly being fired, what he's going to do after this Philadelphia disaster, and everything else that I talked about in this video. Until next time, James Carter TV, I'm out. Peace.